Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. Well, just continuing my experiments with MP3 transfers to cylinders, and I wanted to see how I could do with this 1910 dictaphone. Now, I found this on eBay for $15 in its original hard case, and of course, this thing was frozen solid. It had not run in decades. So, I got it lubed and tuned and working well, and it's been sitting on the shelf now for quite a while. So I just wanted to do some quick experiments to see what kind of recordings I could make on this machine. Now, I've done some experimental recordings, music recordings, voice recordings, MP3 transfer recordings, on a couple of other dictation machines, but never one this old. And this machine is 110 years old, and it's actually running quite well. And other than some basic adjustments, lubing, and tuning, I didn't have to do anything to it at all. Like I said, it was just completely frozen. When I took it out of the box, it was just covered in oxide, and it was obvious that it had not been run probably as long as I've been alive. Very, very old machine. So just continuing these experiments with an MP3 transfer, recording this with the audio driver, of course, and actually recording this on my cell phone as an M4A audio file, and then I'm going to transfer it directly to the cylinder. So I just wanted to do a quick follow-up recording. This is, I refer to this dictation machines as a poor man's cylinder phonograph. You can do a lot with them. It's just a matter of spending some time getting to know them, getting them tuned so they work well. But you can make some surprisingly good recordings on a dictation machine. So I just wanted to do a quick video. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email. TheVictrolaGuy@gmail.com. And as always,